Do you fail so much that you're thinking about buying safety pins or safety slings? Let's get into it. So, you're checking out the ForceUSA safety slings and you're wondering, are they worth it? Well, that's what I'm gonna tell you in today's video. I've had the ForceUSA MyRack safety slings for about 2 years and they've been absolutely fantastic. So, what are some differences between the slings, the pins, and spar arms? The slings are basically a canvas material wrapped around two pins that are bolted to your upright. Along with that, they're also much quieter than safety pins because of the fact that they're a canvas material. They disperse that weight and it's not a metal on metal contact. Another great thing about safety slings is they're adjustable. They are very versatile when it comes to adjustability because you can place one of the mounts lower or higher than the other mount because they're only connected by that rope. This means that you can actually adjust the angle of your spotter arms. For example, if you fail a squat, when that weight crashes onto those safety slings, it can actually roll away from you, which is something that a lot of people prefer when they're debating whether or not they want to go for slings or pins. Now, safety pins is usually a metal tube that slides all the way through the upright, all the way back to the back upright, and is held in by some sort of bend or collar. ForceUSA offers safety tubes, which is basically the same concept, but it attaches on the inside of your rack and it's made of a square tube rather than a round tube. Now these also offer a fixed height, meaning that you can't adjust them so that way the weight can fall behind you or in front of you. When that weight falls, it's gonna stay exactly where it is. So if you place them too low, say on a bench press, you might find yourself in some trouble. Now safety pins are also really nice because they're actually, in my opinion, much faster than safety slings because I find it a little tedious to be tweaking the adjustments of the safety slings when I'm changing in between multiple lifts, like the squat to the bench press. Now to make this a little easier on you, you can use these little colored dots to mark your areas where you put the safety slings, so that way it's always in the same spot and you can just go to that coordinated color. So for the safety arms, these are usually best for lifts outside of the rack because they don't cover the whole interior of the rack. Now you can still put them on the inside, they're just not gonna go from upright to upright. So usually people will put them on the outside of their rack and then bench from the rack or squat or do whatever lift they wanna do outside of the rack and have that spot. It'll expand your real estate and you're no longer confined inside of that rack. So doing some research on this topic, a lot of people say that safety slings are actually a lot safer than pins. Because of the weight crashing down on the pins, all that weight is going to be placed on the welds of those safety pins. Welds can fail, thus making these safety slings a lot safer. I don't know if that logic makes sense. I'm wondering if the same could be said for the safety slings because there's a metal bracket holding that safety sling to the other upright. So there's welds on there that can break. Another thing that could break is the stitching. I've often wondered if that stitching will rip over time due to the knurling of the bar and thus creating a weak stitch and my safety slings to fail earlier than a safety pin would fail. If I were to put my life on a weld over a stitch, I think I would choose the weld. But that's just something I thought of. I haven't looked at statistics of safety pins versus safety slings, and I don't even know if there are any statistics like that. So what's the consensus? Well, I reached out to you guys on Instagram and said, hey, what do you prefer, safety slings or safety pins? And majority took the safety slings. Everybody seems to love them, both on Instagram and when you search on Google. They're adjustable, they're quiet, and a really cool aspect is they prevent damage to your barbell. And what bad comes from preserving your equipment as much as you possibly can? So overall, I love the safety slings. Absolutely love them. Glad I got them. Sometimes I do wish I had safety pins because I spend a lot of time in my workouts adjusting these things, and it's something that I don't look forward to doing. But overall, they do exactly what they need to do, and for ForceUSA, they're the same exact price as the other options, and if you bought the ForceUSA MyRack, you know that it doesn't come with any safety options. So you gotta get one. Why not get the safety slings because of those reasons? Let me know in the comments, pins or slings. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe button. Also, share with your friends. And if you want to support us because you love what we're doing here at They Call Us Outliers, check out our website, theycallusoutliers.com. Check out our merch. That's where you can get all of our stuff, all of our exclusive content. My beautiful wife prints all of our merch in-house, so you can check her out at beyond_capability_empire. The link is down in the description. As always, thank you so much for viewing this video. We'll see you next time. My UPS came into the gym the other day while I was working out, and he said, "Hey man, you want a real challenge? You gotta stop doing that air bike. Check out Stephanie Millinger on YouTube and try out the 17-minute plank." So, well, I guess that's the end of that. Thank God.